DaVinci Resolve 19 is officially live. So most of you have probably downloaded or updated it a few days ago. But me, you know, I like living on the edge. So I've been using the beta version from the day it released a few months ago. And yeah, I've been using it every single day. So in this video, I wanna show you what new features I've been using the most and also some features that have improved now that it's officially released. And I'll also show you why and how I use them. And this video is also another attempt to convert all of you Premiere Pro and Final Cut Pro users by showing you that the learning curve is becoming less and less steep, in my opinion. Yeah, I know you're all here watching these Resolve videos, so here we go. First of all, the Film Look Creator. And this is a feature that I've been using literally every single day. Well, no, that's not true, not literally. But you know, when people say literally these days, they actually don't mean literally. It's like literally has literally lost its meaning these days. Yeah, but anyway, wow, my brain is going into overdrive. I've been using it almost every day. That's what I wanted to say. And now they've also added an extra feature. You can now choose between these film stock emulations, which they call Core Looks. And from what I understand, what I read online, Akasaka is a Fuji emulation because Akasaka is where the Fujifilm HQ is located. And Rochester is a Kodak emulation because that's where they are located. I haven't found out yet what specific stocks the other names are, so if you know, just drop it in the comments. Now, I know it's called the Film Look Creator, but don't focus too much on that word film because I use it as a look creator, not a film look creator. I use it when I want a cool look, fast and easy, because you can basically create any look you want super fast and you don't even have to go to the color page and deal with nodes and stuff like that. In the edit page, for example, drop an adjustment clip on your video and then drop the Film Look Creator on that adjustment clip and boom, done. You can now use it for all your clips and adjust the settings in the inspector window. So it's perfect for beginners, for people who don't want to spend a lot of time color grading, or for people who are still not used to node-based grading. People who are coming from Final Cut Pro or Premiere Pro, for example. You know, now is the time to switch. I use it whenever I need to quickly color grade some B-roll or a short or a reel. Quick and easy, that's what it's all about. Even if I don't want a film look. Okay, the IntelliTracker. Initially I thought, wow, cool update, an intelligent tracker. But I'm always a bit skeptic when it comes to AI and then they call it intelligent, you know? I have to see it before I believe it. And well, I saw and I am believing now. Yeah, it's great. So if you've been using the point tracker until now to stick text to a moving object, for example, well, you've probably also run into this problem when an object moves too fast. Point tracker a lot of times can't really handle it. But the IntelliTracker handles fast objects a lot better, and it has made tracking stuff so much easier and less frustrating. No more manually adjusting keyframes and stuff like that, you know? I don't even use the point tracker anymore. And you can use the IntelliTracker in the color page, the fusion page, and the Fairlight page to track audio. And you know, talking about audio, let's also talk about audio with DoubleEye, the sponsor of this video. Because Blackmagic Design is not the only company constantly adding and improving features. If you're looking for great music or sound effects, audio has you covered. And you can of course do a manual search using keywords or filters, or you can use Link Match AI, for example. Just copy paste a link to a video on YouTube or a song on Spotify in Link Match AI, and it will find the closest match for you in audio's entire library. And it's all music from real artists, so no generic sounding stock music. You can use their music for personal work and commercial client work. And if you don't like the full song, you can now also download all the individual instruments separately. So go check it out and use my link and code in the description to get 70% off a pro subscription. So that's just $59 for a 1-year subscription, which will give you all of these features. Okay, and now back to Resolve. Color Slice is available in the free version, but I've been using it in combination with the Film Look Creator, which is only available in the studio version. But in my opinion, it's super underrated. If I want some more control over the color adjustments, I just put an extra node in front of the Film Look Creator, and that allows me to adjust some specific colors. See? And again, Color Slice is being promoted as, you know, a way to get film-like colors, but I use it more as an easy version of the curves and the color wheels. It gives you more control over the colors, but it's still pretty beginner friendly because you can see what each color wheel will affect. And so, yeah, I like that, again, if you're switching from Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro, you don't have to jump into a complicated node workflow right away. You can keep it super simple in the beginning, but still get great results. This is a feature that I discovered after watching one of Mr. Alex Tech's videos. Definitely go check out his channel if you want some more excellent DaVinci Resolve content. And it's something really small, but because I use a lot of text in my videos to add context or specifications or, you know, things like that, I've been using it a lot. So if you use Text Plus now and then enable the Fusion overlay here, you can now edit and highlight text in the viewer instead of going to the inspector window. So yeah, it's a small update, but it does make editing just a tiny little bit more enjoyable and comfortable. Superscale is an AI feature that they've been constantly improving, and yeah, I use it quite often. Now, why do I find it so useful? Well, I have a ton of stock footage, right? Old stock footage, that's 1080p. So HD, but I shoot my videos in 4K, so I love it that I can easily upscale all of that footage now to 4K or even 8K, and it looks great. There's a bunch of different options that you can try out, and it works really smooth and fast. Well, on my Mac Studio at least. And then there's another AI feature that I really like, one that allows you to be a bit creative. And I love it for the exact same reason, actually. A lot of that old stock footage is shot in 24 frames per second, but sometimes I want to slow it down. And SpeedWarp does that. It allows you to slow down footage that was shot in low frame rates, 24, 30 FPS. Now, it does require a lot of GPU power, so it's not something I use on 20 different clips in a video, but it looks great. Also, for example, when I forget to adjust the frame rate when I'm shooting videos myself. You know, I want to shoot some 60 FPS footage, but then I forget to put it in 60 FPS, and when I come back home, I see that it's just 24. Well, SpeedWarp will slow it down, no problem. So, guys, look, if these features, this video, still can't convince you Premiere Pro and Final Cut Pro users to switch to DaVinci Resolve, then, well, I'll just try again in the next video. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.